Dans notre prochain reportage, le lieutenant-colonel Mike Vernon raconte le combat qu'a mené une compagnie de carabiniers pendant une semaine afin de protéger un poste de contrôle situé près de leur base de patrouille.
In our next report from Afghanistan, Lieutenant Colonel Mike Vernon details one rifle company's week-long struggle to protect a checkpoint close to their patrol base.
Charles Company's immediate reaction force is on the move. There's been another attack. Members of Captain Anian's platoon mount up and move out to reinforce the soldiers defending the checkpoint. Canadians recently began bolstering existing Afghan National Army checkpoints and building new ones in an effort to disrupt the insurgents' freedom of movement. Ever since Canadians began living in checkpoints, they've come under fire, sometimes twice a day.
We took contact from all along the east over there around 10 a.m. Just a bunch of small arms. They shot at the guys in the open that were at us in the open when we were filling sandbags. We returned fire and just held position, and they contact broke.
This is a daylight attack on a nearby observation post.
Scotty's back under contact.
Yeah, back under contact.
Okay, roger that.
Sometimes stray bullets from these attacks strike inside Charles Company's main patrol base. The engineers go into action with their Badger. They will also rip up 5 trees in the area, denying cover to the insurgents. While the engineers work, a soldier who specializes in civil-military cooperation speaks with 2 locals. He'll help if the property owner seeks compensation for today's damages.
We have set formulas for however many meters of wall or a certain size of grape pot, number of plants damaged. So basically, I'll have to talk to them first, and I will get a figure of what they think it's worth. And then we'll add our formulation to that, and we'll come up with something in between.
In a nearby compound, the platoon finds materials that could be used to make improvised explosive devices.
Components. What do you got in your backpack? 155 shell?
No, more components.
Okay. Living the dream.
Well, we found a fairly significant IED component cache. There was 5 81mm mortars. 2 60mm mortars. There was all kinds of shrapnel and different things that they tend to put in the DFFCs to blow out and hit the dismounts. Found wire, found objects that they make pressure plates out of.
What the soldiers don't take away for analysis, they move to a grape hut.
We're going to burn the refuse in the grape hut. It's unsafe for the engineers to search it. So the easiest way of doing it is to burn it all off. We've got permission. And that way, if there's anything inside of there, we'll either destroy it or it'll expose it so we can come back and get it later.
We good?
Yeah, go. Put her all the way back there, didn't you? There you go. Okay. All right, grab your stuff. Start extracting. Yeah. All right, let's go. Come on.
For the first time in a week, life gets a little quieter for Charles Company. For Army News in Afghanistan, I'm Lieutenant Colonel Mike Vernon.